And for some of us, it, we feel like we sort of pulled through a hedge backwards. But here we are with this very precious space where we can discuss and catch on to some of those things that started really with a dialogue this time last year. It's great to see Fiona Sampson here. We had a session with other colleagues at Kingston University talking about what creating a lyric was all about and how we create that in performance as well as creating it through fantastic acts of authorship and composition. And that was very closely followed by a session here in Chancellor's the Small, which Kathryn got together, and beginning these very difficult questions of what we actually do when we perform and how we can talk about it, and the acts of translation that are demanded from us as we move around poetry and music and the various kinds of presentation that performing arts of us. And I'm really grateful to Kathryn for pushing this through, because out of that session last year, we've created this network called SongArt, which is completely open. You're all very, some of you are members of it already. Everybody's very welcome to be members. Kathryn and I will maybe have a word about that later, because we're seeing very much what we'd like to do from today's session. So I think when we get to the round table point, we'll be asking each other and you where we should take it from here. Because what we're looking for is like-minded people. I was going to say lunatics, but I don't really mean that. People who are interested in examining what it is they do, but actually enhancing the doing of it and starting from the doing of it and going back to the doing of it. This is all about action, the taking of action and the enhancing of action. And if at any point you feel some of us who are a bit theoretically minded are going off on one that takes away from that, would you please complain? This is going to be a session with discussion. There will be a round table. And when I say complain, I mean please do it honestly, courteously, and wait for considerable pauses. Thoughtfulness there from Fiona. But the point being is that we're all about discussion, discourse, theory, but in relation to what we feel we need to ask. That's quite a big question. We're very grateful to the IMR for hosting today's session. I think the IMR would agree with this if I said that today is very much sort of evidence and witness to how their facilitation, their bringing together of different kinds of researchers, can really help enhance practice-based areas of research, but all sorts of areas where we're seeking to cross boundaries. John Irving, the director of the IMR, sends his apologies today. He's really sorry he can't be with us. He will be with us in spirit. And huge thanks to Valerie James, who as always does administrative miracles in making things happen. And as I say, I'm also very grateful to Kathryn, who's beaved away and got this all together. Our plot, and it was very much my plot too, was today to bring the dialogue moving out from those of us who call ourselves musicians towards other arts where the lyric and poetry and the whole idea of crossing those boundaries are also important. So we have today, I said, the poet Fiona Sampson, we're also moving to areas of drama and different sorts of ways in which, by sharing our experiences of what we think happens when we perform, we might get nearer to that tantalising prospect, which Kathryn's title has given us, of mapping the interior of song, mapping the interiority. We have no inhibitions today about saying we're entering into a very resolutely personal or subjective area. I think we have to be brave about that. This is what this today needs to be there for, very, very friendly, very interactive, because we're dealing with what my favourite song theorist, Johan Gottfried Herder, I have to get in quickly, sorry about this, what he called the I sing. In other words, that when we hear a song, when a song is made, what we are hearing is a poet saying, and by a poet it could be a singer, it could be all sorts of people, but hearing a poet say, I sing. So it's that very personal act, that very personal utterance. But I would suggest that the I sing is an appeal for others to respond with, I hear that you sing. So it's very much that trying to cross the boundary between the subject singing and an object being made, a response that allows us to say an event has happened, that we remember, that we record as significant, and that we can talk about. So that's really what we're getting at today. That eventness would be one way of putting it. We could call it some kind of objectivity, but I hope you all agree with Goethe that the whole point about calling something an object is that it has to dialogue with the subject. So in other words, the whole point of criticism...
It was a bomb.
Yeah, exactly. The whole point of criticism, and I wonder whether in a way reflective act of performance is how we make the subject become the object and the object become the subject. There's a constant switching between those two things. Something for us to ponder with as we